Hey, get out of there, creepers. You haven't even bought me a drink yet. Which is why I'm making my signature Halloween cocktail, Tequila Sun Eyes. Say aye to my ex-boyfriend. He never did see things my way. Hello, darling. I'm Elvira, Mistress of the Dark and Madam of your Dark Heart. And I'm here to host Funnier Dies Halloween Anthology. You know, I have to be honest, freaks. I never cared that much for funny. But death makes mommy so happy. I feel right at home here in this dark, sexy pleasure palace. But it's not for everyone. I know other people who feel more at home in crypts, graveyards, or even haunted houses. Oh, okay, come on in. All the magic happens right here between these two.
Satanic sculptor Doug and terrible gymnast Donna are braving New England's pricey real estate market to purchase their first house.
Things we have enough room for a torture den.
I just want to be unhappy.
Donna wants a house with a nursery and a walk-in closet, while Doug wants a man cave to hang out with his bros.
My bros are bats.
They've teamed up with real estate agent Jesse to find their first and last home.
I'm an expert in ritual occult, undead spiritualism, and Vermont real estate. I am going to find the perfect haunted house for this family, all for under $350,000.
House number one was a classic New England ranch with a tortured past.
So this is 3-bedroom, 2-bath, and it's right down the street from where you teach shitty gymnastics. And as you can see, there's still blood on the walls from the mass suicide.
I know 30 people died here, but I just can't feel their presence.
Yeah, but check out these bay windows.
House number two was a Victorian with some real spirits living inside.
Yeah, lawn's nice and dead.
Yeah, the haunted house market is tough. Sometimes you find a great haunted house and then somebody comes in and sages it, and then what? You just have a regular house.
Whoops. Yes!
Yeah, I got you.
Very shitty.
Plus, a spacious man cave for Doug.
My bros are gonna love hanging out here. My bros are bats.
And house number three was the perfect place to raise their child.
Yes, very dark.
Yeah, it's spooky, but is it spooky enough?
Help me find my dolls.
I mean, that's good, but where's the open floor plan, okay?
Donna and Doug have a big decision ahead of them.
I don't know. House number one did have that historic cult suicide.
I mean, house number three was great. It had that clear child apparition. Plus, I really liked that it had all that unfinished business.
Yeah, well, listen, speaking of business, there's a lot of business to do in that basement there. You know, I mean, I don't know where a torture den would go.
I think Doug's just gonna have to lower his expectations a little bit. I know he really wants a place to hang out with his bros. His bros are bats.
You like house number two.
You know, that man cave was a literal cave.
I want something that screams us. And I want that screaming to keep us up all night long.
Well, I think I've made my decision.
I think I know too.
Let's say it on three.
Okay,
you ready?
Ready?
Okay, one,
ready.
One, two, three.
House number
three.
The price, the neighborhood, and the dead little girl made this the perfect house for Donna and Doug. Now they are bleeding out on their living room floor, and they know they found the perfect home.
I love this house.
Perfect.
Well, weren't they a lovely couple? No, not these. The couple in the sketch. I mean, if you like that kind of stuff, you know, love, marriage, dying with your spouse. I prefer to outlive all my boyfriends. One of my boyfriends talked me into having a threesome with this ghoul from the office. That was a trick and a treat. The six-pack is right over there. Best part of him. Now, let me ask you Funny or Dire's a serious question. Have you ever been alone in a house and convinced yourself that everything was out to kill you? Admit it. You were probably high, right? So is my girl, Tina. And die, stoner, die. Come on, come to mama.
I'm Jake from the rental office. I'm here to fix the kitchen sink. I didn't think anyone was here this weekend, so...
I'm friends with Travis and Jen, the owners. They said it was available, so I'm here. I came up. They said it was cool.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I didn't mean to barge in. Sorry.
Should I have told somebody I was here?
It's fine. This happens. It's okay. Fine. I should have checked. I didn't double check.
yeah.
Well, I'll let the ladies at the office know you're here by yourself.
Okay.
I'll get out of your hair.
Okay. Woo! Hey, he's trying to do his job. I'm gonna try and do my job. It's fine.
Hi, I'm Jake from the rental office. I'm here to fix the kitchen sink. I'll let the ladies at the office know you're here by yourself. By yourself. By yourself.
No, no, no. Okay.
Hello?
Hey, Jason.
What's up?
Hey, you've got to call 911.
What?
I'm hyperventilating and okay. I think I'm having a heart attack and there's someone here who wants to kill me.
Someone... What?
The categories has something to do with it, Jason. Categories!
The game?
Oh, my God. Oh, God.
Hello? Tina? Tina?
We played it when Christmas, but your family got so bad.
Are you high?
It calms me down, Jason, okay?
You don't seem calm.
I've locked all the doors and everything.
Tina?
Oh, my God. Jason, he has a key. He can get in here anytime he wants and murder me.
Calm down for 1 second.
Jason, call the police. Call 911.
Why can't you call them?
Now! Oh, God.
Your brain can be the scariest place of all. When I was a little nipper of the dark, I had this frightening thought that I would never date a nice guy. Well, I'm happy to report that I've dated lots of nice guys who all happen to be dead now. Eh, what an incredible coinkydink. No, not quite yet, darling. Still talking. Our next video is about... It's about... I forgot what our next video is about. Oh, footage. Our next video is about found footage. Now you may enter.
What are you doing with that camera?
It's for my documentary course, studying the paranormal.
For real? You're kind of freaking me out here, babe. Check it out, babe. I got a camera, too. That way I can catch some of the action.
Can I help?
Depends, man. You got a camera we could cut to?
You're on the team.
What's that sound mean?
The ghost detector says there's a lot of activity in that camera superstore.
Let's check it out. Whoa, look at all these cameras. And they all happen to be aiming at us.
Did you hear that? A ghost!
What's that it's holding?
It's a team of ghost documentarians.
Go, go!
If someone finds all the thousands of hours of this footage, please, please cut it into a feature-length film.
This was my boyfriend Phil from Cleveland. Never learned how to toe the line between a good guy and someone who sends naughty pics to the werewolves down the block. Ew. Sorry, but holding an open wound is so dangerous. So is sticking your finger in any of the Kardashians. Or an electrical socket. You know, they say it makes you go crazy, like this breathy killer in the next video. Warning, it's not what you think.
Baby girl, you're a star.
I think you're just seeing people again.
You're probably right.
I want to be outside!
Right,
oh
baby.
My god! Oh my god!
Please drop the weapon. Drop the weapon.
What?
I said drop the weapon!
You're gonna have to speak up!
Drop the weapon!
What?
The weapon!
What?
I said drop the weapon!
Excuse me?
Wait. Mr. Childers? What are you doing?
This old damn floozy with all that disco music. I can't get any sleep with all that racket.
Mr. Childers, it's 7:30 p.m. Now, we've been over this before. You can't just go around chasing sorority girls with your gardening shears. Mr. Childers, I gotta ask you, did you kill any sorority girls in there?
I don't think so.
All right, come on, let's get you home, okay?
Well, before we go, could you tie my shoe?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Are these new? These are awesome shoes.
Oh, gosh, these feet. The feet stink.
Roast in hell, pig.
Oops, you dropped your clippers here. Don't worry, I'll carry them for you.
Son of a bitch.
What was that?
Well, you little monsters, me and my ex, Stan, want to stay here and show you more, but we have a date tonight. We're rekindling our relationship. Kinda. Isn't it cute? I just took the best parts of all my exes. Well, happy Halloween, freaks. And remember, one of the scariest things in the world is me in a turtleneck. If you ever see that, run for your lives, because it's the Midwest zombie apocalypse.